Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is Cactus 1549. We've lost both engines.
Cactus 1549, do you need to return to LaGuardia?
We can't make it. We're going to end up in the Hudson. When this came in, I fought tooth and nail. I didn't want to read the screenplay, because if you read a screenplay that's great, you fall in love with it, your life, you're just disappointed. And then somebody else makes the movie and you feel like an idiot because I could have done that. I'm so stupid. But I must say, I read Todd's screenplay almost against my will. I feel as though I read it in 17 minutes. It was incredibly powerful, and I was speaking with my wife. And she sort of did that thing from Clint Eastwood come in. I said, yeah, it did. Well, how is it? Oh, it's pretty great. It's really great. She says, well, then you might have to do it. I said, yeah, I'm afraid I'm going to have to do it.
Tom is one of our best actors, and it was a privilege, and with the boss as well. So, I mean, I can't gush on him all the time, but it was wonderful to be around both of them. I learned a lot, and even having Soli in the simulator, you know, it really, really helps you. Gives you confidence. It's great having them around because you have the real story. You have the expertise. You know, you can call somebody up or ask them, "Hey, how did you put your seatbelt on? How did you adjust your seat when you got in?"
Everyone involved worked so hard to make this real.
I talked to Jeff. Jeff is still flying the transatlantic route right now, right? I mean, he has 15,000 hours. Great guy. And the interesting thing is that's the first time he ever flown an Airbus A320.
I just love the reaction New Yorkers had to this whole incident. And around the world, everybody, no matter where you were, that iconic picture of Captain Sullenberger's last flight on the water and all the people standing on the wings.
We landed on a protected inland waterway where, you know, there's not a sea state or huge swells to worry about, where rescue could happen literally with minutes. The first New York waterway ferry arrived 3:55 after we stopped in the river because they'd seen us and they radioed the vessels to head toward us. It was a very difficult thing, the hardest day, the worst day of my life, and ultimately the best day.
It wasn't just me. It was all of us. It was Jeff and Donna and Sheila and Doreen and all of the passengers, the rescue workers, air traffic control, ferry boat crews and the scuba cops. We all did it. We survived.